JDK, JRE, JVM. Three acronyms that can strike fear into the heart of any budding Java developer. Well, maybe not fear, but certainly confusing. So let's have a talk about it and figure out what these three acronyms are all about. This video is brought to you by the Learn Programming Academy's Java Masterclass. With 77 hours of video training, 320,000 students and tens of thousands of glowing reviews, this truly is the best way to learn Java. Grab a massive discount and instant access by visiting lpa.dev/YouTube Java or by clicking on the link in the description of this video. Welcome back. My name is Tim Buchalka with another programming tip of the day. We're talking about the JDK, the JRE, and the JVM. We're going to come through and find out, hopefully by the end of the video, what they all mean. So let's start with the JDK. Well, the JDK stands for the Java Development Kit, and it's basically just that. It's the development kit that you need to create Java programs. Now, there's a version for it for both Windows, Mac, and Linux. Basically, it's the tools that will take your Java source code, the code that you write, and convert them into a format that the JRE and the JVM, which we'll talk about shortly, can execute. So it includes things like debuggers for testing, for finding errors in your code, but also the Java compiler for compiling that code. So that's the Java Development Kit. So moving on, the next one is the JRE, and JRE stands for the Java Runtime Environment. So firstly, the Java Runtime Edition, the JRE, actually includes the JVM, which is the Java Virtual Machine, but we'll talk more about the JVM a little bit later in the video. So what's included in the JRE, and in fact, what's it all about? Well, the JRE, as you probably guessed by the word runtime in the Java runtime environment, is used to run your Java program. So it basically includes the libraries, set of different libraries that come with Java, the various functionality that you can basically execute in your Java code, but also a Java launcher. And as I mentioned, it also includes the Java virtual machine. And there's a version of that for Windows, Mac, and Linux as well. And interestingly enough, the Java Development Kit comes bundled with the Java Runtime Edition as well. Now, in previous versions, that wasn't the case, and as a developer, you would have to have installed both versions on your computer, but that's no longer the case. So basically, with the Java Runtime Environment, any person who wants to run Java code has to have the Java Runtime Edition installed on their computer to do so. Now, the Java Runtime Edition, just to be clear, doesn't include any development tools. So you can't develop programs with the Java Runtime Environment. You actually run the code that's created with the tools in the Java Development Kit using the Java Runtime Edition. All right, so moving on. Now, before I start talking about the Java Virtual Machine, which is what the JVM stands for, you need to have a bit of an understanding how traditional computer programming languages work. Now, we'll take the example of C++. Now, a C++ compiler, which compiles your C++ code, compiles it into the hardware, or it makes it work with the hardware that it's currently being compiled on. So if you're running a C++ compiler on your Windows Intel machine, it'll create a version, an executable version of the code that will execute only on an Intel platform computer. You won't be able to take that executable code and run it on a different architecture machine, like a Solaris Unix machine, for example. So that's how traditional programming languages like C++ actually compile programs into that format. Now, Java takes a different approach. The Java Virtual Machine, and this is part of the Java Runtime Environment, that's effectively an abstract computing machine. That's really what it is. And the Java Virtual Machine, the JVM, knows nothing about the Java programming language. All it knows, all it can do is work with compiled Java code. So essentially, the Java Virtual Machine is all more or less like a physical machine, but it's an abstract concept. So it's a virtual machine that runs on your computer. So when you actually execute a program from the Java Runtime Environment, it runs this virtual machine, and that's how your code's actually executed. And that probably sounds a little bit confusing, but essentially the Java Development Kit creates or takes the Java code that you've written and creates these class files, .class files, and you may have seen those when you've been working with Java. And those class files are actually executed or can be executed by the Java Virtual Machine. So that's basically the process. The Java Development Kit takes the Java code that you've typed into us in a typical editor or IDE such as IntelliJ, creates a class file, a .class file. That class file can be executed via the Java Runtime Environment in the Java Virtual Machine. And as I mentioned, the Java Virtual Machine is bundled with the Java JRE, the Java Runtime Environment. Now, in terms of the Java Runtime Edition and the JVM, that runs on many devices. So basically what happens is a manufacturer or a vendor, someone who creates an operating system or whatever, they will actually produce a version of the Java virtual machine based on the specifications that Oracle have available. And as soon as they do that and they implement that Java virtual machine, that means you can take your Java code and run it on their virtual machine. So this is how Java achieves the ability to run on so many different devices and so many different operating systems. It's running a different Java virtual machine, which has been written for that particular operating system or machine, the hardware as well. So I think that's a pretty interesting concept of how Oracle and actually Sun, because they were the original creators of the Java product, how they built this concept of a virtual machine. And from there, you're running your code in a virtual machine, and therefore it can run on any device or any operating system that actually has a version of the Java virtual machine and are very widely used out in the industry. All right, so that's really the concept. Now, one other thing I'd like to address before we finish the video is the slowness. Because if you think about it, C++ code, as an example, that produces native code. So in other words, when you compile the code, it produces a version of that code that runs on that specific hardware, and there's no abstraction layer. So it's basically straight into that hardware. And that's how C++ is actually going to run faster in general than a Java program. And again, that's because the Java program is working on a Java virtual machine. So it's basically abstracting that concept. The Java virtual machine is then producing the machine code that actually runs the actual code. So you can see that there's a two-step process with Java code as opposed to a one-step process with a C++ executable. So that's why in the past, Java has been fairly slow, or known as fairly slow. And if you do any research, you'll see that a lot of people still think that Java is extremely slow. But in general, Java is now a lot faster. A couple of reasons. Firstly, there's a lot of efficiencies and optimizations that have gone on in Java virtual machines over the last probably 20, 25 years that Java's been around. But secondly, computer hardware these days is so much faster and so much more powerful that's really making the fact that there's a virtual machine running almost a non-issue. So if you're worried about Java being slower than perhaps traditional programming languages, more or less that feature has gone away, and it's really only things like, you know, really intensive graphical applications, games, and those sorts of things that you'll really notice the performance differences between, say, C++, which is a common language for that sort of those sort of applications, and Java. All right, so that's basically it. That's the overview. So hopefully now you understand the differences between the JDK, Java Development Kit, Java Runtime Environment, JRE, and the JVM, Java Virtual Machine. Alrighty, so I hope that helped. If you've got any questions, feel free to leave a comment and I'll get back to you. If you're ready to look at the next tip, click on up here and you can check that out. If you're interested in coding specific programming videos, click on the link in the bottom left-hand corner. Consider subscribing by clicking on the link up here, and I'll see you soon.